Namaste everyone from Joy of Reading. Today's story is Golu, Festival of Dolls. The author is Surekha Reddy. The illustrators are Debashmita Das Gupta, Deepa Balsavar, Dia Ullas, Gauri Sirur, Priya Kurian. And the publisher is the Story Weaver Community. Navaratri, or the Nine Nights, is the festival celebrated during the autumn season or the Sharad Ritu. As the name signifies, it's a festival celebrated over 9 nights and 10 days. It is celebrated in various parts of India in different ways, but the main significance is the victory of good over evil. Golu, the festival of dolls, is celebrated during Navaratri, especially in South India. Let's find out more about Golu. Golu was around the corner. Juhi's mom always arranges all the dolls for Golu. This time, her mom was out of town. So, Juhi wanted to surprise her mom by arranging the dolls. So the two here is wrong. So that's why I did not read it. But okay. So Golu was around the corner, which meant Navaratri was coming close by. And what did Juhi's mom do during this time? She arranges dolls for Golu. So we saw that Golu is a festival of dolls. So looks like they have to arrange dolls. But this time her mom was out of town. So Juhi wanted to do that herself and surprise her mom. Juhi's mom wraps up the Golu dolls and toys with paper and stores them in this green box. Her mom also makes a list of toys stored in the box. Juhi got the box out of the storeroom. So her mom keeps all the dolls and toys wrapped up in paper in this green colored big box. And her mom also makes a list. Okay, these are the toys present in this box. So first step, Juhi gets the box out. Juhi unwraps the toys very carefully. Look, she found the musical instruments. The veena is the national musical instrument of India. Did you know that? So she unwraps it carefully. Why? Because they will all break. They are either made out of clay or something called paper mache. So you have to be very careful while you handle them. And what did she find? Many different musical instruments. This is a harmonium. This is a veena. And these are all different types of tablas that are there. So she finds this wonderful set of musical instruments. And veena that is seen here is the musical, national musical instrument of India. Juhi found the stainless steel kitchen playset. There is a gas stove also in this kitchen playset. Do you like the kitchen playset? So the other thing she found from this whole box is a kitchen playset. Look at it. It has a ladle, it has plates, it has tumblers. It has spoons, and you look at this small, cute little gas stove that is also there, and this is a pressure cooker. Isn't that really neat? Juhi asked her grandma to help her to arrange the dolls and toys for Golu. Her grandma was glad to help. So Juhi goes to her grandma and says, "Grandma, please help me so that I can keep the dolls." So her grandma said, "Yes, I will help you." Juhi and her grandma started arranging the dolls and toys. Look at the pink set of nesting dolls. Do you like the pink nesting dolls? So look at them. They've kept steps here and they've slowly started placing the dolls there. And did you see this pink set of nesting dolls, which means like one is, you know, the one is big, next one is slightly less, you know, slightly lesser in size. The next one is even smaller. The next one is even smaller. No, they all are decreasing in size. Those are the pink nesting dolls that they have there. Juhi is almost done with arranging the dolls and toys. Every year, her mom buys a new toy for Golu. Juhi wanted to buy one this year. So during Golu, everyone gets at least one more toy so that they can keep this new toy for the Golu as well, or the new doll for the Golu. So that's a custom that is followed. So this year, after she has kept all the dolls that her mother has already stored in the green box, she wants to get one new toy according to tradition. So let's see what she does. Juhi went to the market. She was looking for a doll, but she saw so many other toys, not a doll. She thought of making a doll all by herself. So she goes to the market to buy a doll, but she was not happy with anything that was there. So what does she do? She decides, I will make the doll myself. So that's what she's going to do. Juhi bought some clay from the market. She molded the clay and made the doll. She also made two little birds. There's a typo here where made is given twice, so we only read once. So what does Juhi do? She got some clay from the market. And then you can see her, she's making the doll herself. And look at what a beautiful doll she has made. Along with this doll, she has also made two small little birds as well. Isn't that really nice of Juhi? Juhi made a beautiful rangoli in front of the Golu. She kept everything ready. So after keeping the Golu on the steps, she also draws this beautiful pattern with colors on the ground that is called as rangoli. So this is anywhere that is auspicious, a rangoli or a kolam is drawn. And that is what Juhi did. Rangoli also means a beautiful pattern on the floor, drawn with flour, rice flour mainly. And then you put colors as well in it so that it looks really beautiful. The next day, Juhi's mom was back. She was surprised to see everything arranged for Golu. She was proud of Juhi. So when Juhi's mom comes back, she's surprised to see those beautifully, those dolls arranged beautifully. And she's very happy. She was so proud. She was like, oh, Juhi's so responsible. How so sweet of her, right? So she was very happy. Juhi and her family were ready to welcome friends to their house to celebrate Golu, the festival of dolls. So now they're all set. So what happens during this Navratri and you have this Golu? You invite friends and your family. Golu is a festival of dolls celebrated in South India during Navratri. All the family members join to clean up the house, unpack the dolls, and arrange them on the steps. So, as I said before, Golu is a festival of dolls celebrated during Navratri, especially in South India. And this is an occasion where friends and family get together. Families invite other families to see their dolls in their house. It's a great social occasion, as well as it's a chance for people to exhibit their artistic talents, especially singing. So if you know to sing, you're asked to sing. And while the guests leave the house, they're also given, the lady guests especially are given tambulam, which is nothing but betel leaves, betel nuts, turmeric, and also the vermilion that you apply on your forehead. I hope you enjoyed the story of Golu with me. Thank you. Here is a Golu for you to enjoy. This Golu consists of 7 steps. At the topmost 2 steps, you can see gods from different temples in South India. The next 2 steps have Dashavatara and the 8 Lakshmis. You also have
Lord Rama. And then in the next two steps, there are scenes that are depicted from Krishna's life. You can see Krishna dancing on Kaliya, he killing the demoness Putana, and also the Govardhana hill, where he lifts up the Govardhana hill and finally killing Kamsa. So there are multiple dolls out there. In the last step, there are couple dolls that are there from various states of India. Here you have a couple from Sikkim. This is a traditional Vaishnavite couple from South India. You have various type couples out here. And this is a couple from Telangana. This is the traditional Marapachi doll that have to be kept in every gulu. Here you have a set of people playing various musical instruments. And then this is a couple from Rajasthan. Finally, you have the lamp and decorations before the gulu. Here is also a small gulu depicting the procession that happens in the Varadaraja temple of Kanchipuram. So with the priests, with people carrying the palanquin, we have the priests out there and the instruments being played. The whole scene is depicted and the dolls are handmade beautifully. I hope you enjoyed seeing this gulu.
Try this. Write about how you celebrate during Navaratri. Thank you.